Now we're going to be talking about the Super Bowl spot for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. You know, if you guys have seen my review of this film, you know, I thought it was meh. I didn't find it terrible or anything. It has its fun moments, but it's just not a good movie. It's really forgettable.
Sorry, I had to do it again.
Yeah, WWE fans on a different side of the film, which I know you're going to address in a little bit.
Yes.
But, you know, I'll be honest. When I watched the full-length trailer to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2 that just released, I thought it was honestly pretty awful. But then, ironically, when I rewatched that trailer, I'm all like, okay, it's decent. You know, it has a nice flow with the editing and all that. So I thought it was decent. This one, I'll probably say, was decent, too. I probably liked the full-length trailer slightly more if I had to choose between. But, you know, it was very quick, just quick shots. That's all this Super Bowl spot was. But you see the turtles, you see them in the, I guess you could call it the turtle truck. And then you see all these aliens just taking over the town. And, you know, you do see a quick shot of Casey Jones, who is obviously going to be played by Arrow Stephen Amell, which I'm looking forward to.
me too.
Because I'm a big fan of Arrow, so I look forward to that. And, of course, you get another shot of Megan Fox tightening up her shirt, which was like, yeah, we get it. Does there have to be a shot of her, like, tying up her shirt every time, honestly? We get a shot of Rocksteady, like, chasing after Casey Jones, and then we have the turtles up on a plane. That's honestly really it for the Super Bowl spot. There isn't much for me to talk about, but hopefully I'm having some faith in this film. I think it could be maybe at least a little bit better than the first film. So yeah, this one's like more of a decent spot to me, but you know, it's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2. I just hope to have some fun with it.
All right, well, you know, the first movie I thought was pretty bad, honestly. I didn't really like it.
I don't blame you.
It's sad that Fantastic Four is better than Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I know people can be like, what are you talking about? But but yeah, I just thought this movie was bad. It was really, really, really bad. And but man, I gotta be honest, I'm looking forward to this. This looks like Ninja Turtles at its finest. It really does. Like, I hope this is kind of almost the same way that the Power Rangers movie goes, because this is what I want it to be. I want it to be a fun, stupid, entertaining movie, kind of like how it was back in the day. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what definitely seems right here. Like, I mean, you got the humor and stuff, like with, you know, with Michelangelo. And then when we see Krang for the first time, which I thought was awesome. I love that. Immediately when I saw that, I was like, Krang! Like, it was so cool. Which, if you don't know who Krang is, that's the alien thing that is on board on that ship. And then when the brain pops up, Monkey's like, ah! That was pretty funny, actually.
Yeah, I forgot to mention that. Yeah, that was a pretty funny scene at the end.
And then when Rafa gets hit by the plane and stuff, that was pretty funny too. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. It was actually really good, and I'm pretty excited for this movie. This honestly could be really better than the first movie, because it actually does seem like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie. So yeah, and Stephen Amell is Casey Jones, of course. I love it because Stephen Amell's the boy. So
hey there, guys. Thank you so much for watching the Super Bowl trailer review for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of the Super Bowl spot for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2. This is 22 Tiger Dude here, and don't forget that I will always have Tiger Power!